So she said, what's the problem, baby? What's the problem? I don't know. No, baby, I'm in love. And I think about it every time I think about it. And I can't stop thinking about it. How much longer will it take to cure this? Just to cure it, cause I can't ignore it if it's love. And it makes me want to turn around and face it. But I don't know nothing about love. Oh, strawberry ice creams never ever end. All of this love, well, I didn't mean to do it, and there's no escaping your love. Oh, these lines of lightning means we're never alone, never alone. No, no, come on, come on, move a little closer, darling. Come on, come on, I wanna hear you whisper. Settle down inside of my love. Oh, come on, come on, jump a little higher. Come on, come on, if you feel a little lighter. Come on, come on, once upon a time in love. But I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love.
Kelly Mary Roberts, my absolute best friend and my favorite person in the entire world. When I started writing my vows, I thought I would make a list of all the things I love about you. But we only paid for 5 hours of videography, so I'll just say a few. I love your sense of humor. You make me laugh more than anyone ever has. I love the way that you love all living things, whether it's a human or a baby bird. You will give them everything you have to give them the best shot at life. I love the fact that you're amazing at everything you do, being a dog mom, baking cakes, any kind of craft. If you put your mind to it, you're going to do an incredible job. Because of you, I am an exponentially better person than I was before knowing you. Everyone who has ever been lucky enough to know you feels the same way. 3 years ago, we made a pact that if we were both single by age 30, that we would get married. And then a few weeks later, we decided to go on a date, and I knew that there was no way we were going to make it to 30 without getting married. After our third date, when you cooked me that bacon-wrapped chicken with berries and cream for dessert, I knew that you were the one I wanted beside me forever. It was you from the beginning. I promise to show you every day how much I love you. I'll reach things on the top shelf, reverse park your car, and clean the cast iron pan even after we've cooked eggs in it. I vow to stand beside you to be your biggest fan and your best friend, to love you in sickness and in health, to make you laugh and to appreciate the easy silence that we can share together, to continue building this life together with as many dogs as you want.
I was back at the bar.
I vow to show our future children what real, good love looks like and to live a life together that we are proud of. I promise to be on your side, to support you, and to grow with you in whatever our future may hold. I love you with my whole heart, and I will love you till the very end.
But I was just hoping that you would be here. I was something that you ever wanted. I'm all ears.
Mallory, our love story is my favorite. I will spare our guests the stories that involve alcohol for the sake of keeping my vows wedding appropriate. Something has always pulled me towards you. Even before we were officially friends or had met for the first time, I knew I wanted to be in your life somehow. I thought it was just as friends, but here we are. This is where I mentioned the pact that we made, that you already mentioned, to just marry each other at 30 if we were still single. We're overachieving then. It really was you from the beginning, and all of the dots really do connect for me. It was so instant with us. The second I left our first date, I knew I was in trouble. People often ask me, how do I know? And I always say that when you know, you just know. There's no one else I want to do life with, to raise future children with, or to be old retired golfing lesbians with. You are my best friend, and I want to do everything this life has to offer with you. I hear people talk about how hard relationships are and how much work love can be, and I honestly just can't relate. Our love is the easiest thing that I've ever experienced, and these are the things that I vow to you today and every day going forward. I vow to always speak to you with kindness and compassion. I vow to always be your biggest supporter, even when you wear those hideous kayaking shoes. I vow to remind you that even the seemingly smallest accomplishments you do at work means that you are the future Mrs. Beer Store and nothing less. I vow to cherish the everyday moments that we get together and remind myself every day how lucky I am to have you as my partner. I vow to always make the phone calls to set up your appointments or to let restaurants know if your order is wrong or to order the pizza because that one time you did, you ordered pizza in Woodstock, New Brunswick, and then you had to call back and cancel. I vow that you will never have to face this world alone and we will continue to face whatever challenges or adventures we encounter together. I vow to celebrate you and pretend to know what you're talking about when you show me another super cool Excel spreadsheet that you've made. Oh, I never actually promised to let you win at Mario Kart either. Mallory, all jokes aside, because again, I am incredibly nervous at public speaking, I vow to love you so fiercely and passionately with everything that I have to offer. We are partners, teammates, best friends, and I can't wait to grow old with you and continue laughing together forever. I promise to always listen so that you always feel heard, to always see you so that you always feel seen. You are an extraordinary human whose integrity, patience, humor, and kindness is unrivaled, and I vow to choose you and love you every day for the rest of my life.
There was a kiss just waiting to happen. A cab was calling outside the door.
I hope today feels like the first day of a brand new phase of your love. I am confident that there's nothing you two can't face together. One of the greatest privileges of a partnership is knowing that you have one another for all the storms to come and that you'll never weather them alone. Now I'm going to say something you've been waiting some time for. I, Reverend Tori Taylor, by the powers vested in me by the Marriage Act, do hereby pronounce you married. You may seal your agreement with a kiss.
Dirty blonde hair. You were a little bit shy then.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming for the first time as a married couple, Mrs. and Mrs. Roberts.
There was a kiss just waiting to happen. A cab was calling outside the door.